And now we will learn how attorneys will use timesheets to keep track of associate lawyers' hours for different clients. Now, you may well ask, what is a timesheet? And the answer is it's exactly the same thing as the time slip that we learned about in the previous video. It's a document you make to keep track of how much time each associate attorney worked on each client for the week. It's not a transaction. It will not show up in the journal. Instead, it's an event that we document that will become a transaction after placing it on an invoice. And it has its own separate set of reports, and those are the same reports as the time slips. But then you may ask, how do you find a timesheet once you made the timesheet? Well, there are two places. One, you can open up the time slip for that session that happens to be on that sheet. And let's take a look at how to do that now. In other words, by making time slips in the previous video, we actually made time sheets as well. We just didn't look at them. If I open up time by client detail, just like I did in the previous video, and I can see this was made during the week of April, April 23rd, sometime during that week. Now, if I double click, the previous video showed we go back to the time slip that I made. But if you click here, time sheet, you'll get every time slip for that week or for that period of time for that particular customer, okay, or a client. So in this case, it was 6 hours on Tuesday the 23rd. It was for Alan Arby, and these were the notes, and it was not billable, so there was no service item associated with it. However, you can see that if we had more hours on the same week for the same worker, and that worker, Ben, was on the same job, we could just put it here and we could see everything for the week, including the notes. And if he worked on a different client sometime during the week, you could put that in the second row. So let's take a look at another example. If we double clicked Lana for Betty, you could see that this is the time slip that happened on April 22nd, 4 hours for Betty. But if you click the timesheet, you get the same exact thing all the way down to the notes. The difference with this one is that it was marked as billable, so that's what it looks like when you come back to it. And there's a service item because you did mark it as billable and you did put it on an invoice. And again, if she worked other days for Betty, you could put them here on the same timesheet. And each one that you put, each little square that you put, once you save it, QuickBooks will generate a separate single activity time for each individual one that you put in the sheet, and it will associate it with that sheet. You could also find the timesheet by opening the timesheet window and searching both by week and by name, because it's a combination of both week and name that make one specific sheet. So again, you could do this. Customers, enter time, use weekly timesheets. Now, all I have to do is put the week of April 26 and choose the name, Ben the Barrister, and I get Ben's timesheet for that week. I could change it to Lana the Lawyer, and I can get Lana's time for that week. And if I change the week to the prior week, okay, I can get the time for that prior week, for that worker, for that job. And that's how you find it, and that's how you control it. Now, you'll see in our example how it's slightly different from a time slip because it can show several for the week. Let's imagine April 29th, Lana did 7 hours on the Alan Arby job, and it was billable. So we can do this. Customers, enter time, use weekly timesheet. Now we said it was April 29th, so you have to go to the calendar here. Week of April 29th to May 5th. Actually, we should probably, because it's part of that week, so we have to do that. So here's Monday the 29th, and the name of the worker, the name of the associate attorney, is Lana the lawyer, and the job she worked on was Alan Arby. Okay. Now, because it is billable, we do have to put a service item that she rendered. And of course, you could put whatever you want in the notes just to remind yourself of what happened. But it was Monday the 29th and it was 7 hours and I'm going to push tab and leave it marked as billable because there's an item there. Now, I'm not going to save and close just yet because look. Okay, we will save and close because the next one is Ben. But look, when I click save and close, when we look at client time by client detail, it goes added to the same client regardless. So here's a different week, Alan Arby, and this is Lana, okay, and this is legal services rendered for that week. So here's legal services rendered. Here there was no item assigned. You know why? Because in the section of Alan, Alan goes from here to here. And in the section of Alan of the time by client report, the top half is the billable and the bottom half is the ones where the time was assigned but was not billable. That's why it's up in this section. But it's unbilled, which means it's billable and waiting to be billed. And here are the notes. So this report is great. And if you go time by name, you say, okay, Lana has a few more hours. A few more hours working for Alan Arby. So here's Lana. Oops, here's Lana. And it's a few more hours for Alan. If I double click, you can see that these hours on the 20th for Alan were billable and these were not billable. And that's how you control that information. So let's go to the next one. The next one was April 30th for Ben, 6 hours, Betty Boop. Well, let's use a timesheet. We'll go like this. Customers, enter time, use weekly timesheet, okay, and we said it was May 1. So if you click on the date, it'll automatically put the correct week. Then you choose the correct person, and then the information says Betty Boop, 6 hours, not billable. So we choose Betty Boop, and of course, on May 1, April 30, actually it's April 30, it was 6 hours, and we will remove. You must remove the billable check mark because it's there by default. And you could put whatever notes you want, but no service item because this one is not billable. Save and close and look at the report, and you can see same thing for Betty Boop. Here are the billable ones, and then you can see they were already billed. And here are the non-billable ones, no item assigned, in the section of Betty. So we can go back here. May 1, Lana did 5 hours for Betty Boop, the client, not billable. So let's go here. Customers, enter time, use weekly timesheets. And we said that was May 1, 5 hours, Betty and Lana. So we go May 1, Lana is the associate attorney. Oh, look at this. Lana has hours during this week already. That means we can add the May 1 5 hours for Betty to Lana's timesheet. May 1, 5 hours, and it was Betty, and remove the billable check mark. So you can see this is what a timesheet would look like if you had sent out an associate attorney to several clients within 1 week. Each separate event has to be on a separate row so that you can have separate notes and therefore have a separate time slip and decide which particular events are or are not billable. And then, of course, you click save and close. And of course, the reports change accordingly here, and the reports change accordingly here, and you could double click and you could see how many hours for who and why, etc., etc. So now let's do the last one. May 2, 9 hours for Ben, Alan billable. So when we open up the weekly timesheet, okay, it's May 2nd, and it's for Ben. Aha. Now Ben already has hours during this week. which means the next event goes on the next row. And we already said it was for Alan and it's 9 hours billable. So we choose Alan and it's May 2nd, right? Yeah, May 2nd. So you have to put it on a different row. 9 hours and it leave the billable check. But remember, if it's billable, you have to put a service item there. Good. Now save and close. And our time by client detail looks the way we need it to look. And we could double click, drill down and see any detail we need. And our time by name, the same thing. For Ben, these are the hours he worked for each client. For Lana, these are the hours she worked. You can double click the summary and get the detail just for Lana, where she worked on just Alan. And each event you double click brings you back to the slip. And from the slip, you can click and get the timesheet. Now let's round out this example by actually putting it on an invoice and billing. So let's imagine on May 3rd, we billed Alan for only Ben's time. Well, we did click save and close here. So we already remembered how to open an invoice, how to put the proper date on the invoice, choose Alan. Remember, if this pops up, it's not a mistake. It's a normal part of business. If it doesn't pop up, you can always click this button here, but we click OK. And remember, what are we doing in these instructions? Billing Alan for only Ben's time. So here's Ben's time for that week, and we're going to click OK, and then click OK. Now, Ben, we bill Ben out at $33 an hour, so Alan owes us $279. When we click, now remember, this is, when we click save and close, oh yeah, I got to remember to uncheck this. When we click save and close, and we don't want to apply the credits, now before we look at the balance, let's look at time by client. You can see for Alan, this for Ben has now been billed. So of the two that are billable, this was unbilled, and this is billed. Okay, then when we open the client balance detail for Alan, we can see his balance went up by the invoice that we just sent. We double click, we see the invoice right here, legal services rendered $33 an hour from Ben. There you go. Now the last one, May 4th, billed Alan for only Lana's time. So we'll basically do the same thing. We open an invoice, okay, that was May the 4th, be with you. And now we're billing Alan, click OK. This time it's only for Lana's time. Click OK. Now we bill out Lana at $44 an hour. That's $308 that's going to be added to Alan's balance. And the income from legal services rendered goes up when we make the invoice, not when we put it on a timesheet, when we make the invoice. Click save and close. Ignore all the spelling issues. No, don't apply to the credits. Now we come back here and we go to Lana. Okay, look, now they're both billed. Now all of the time for Alan during that week has been billed. And we look at Alan's balance, and Alan's balance went up on May the 4th by $308 because he had to pay for Lana's time as well. And that's how you do it.